Dear students, very good morning. Welcome back from Bharat sir. You all know chemistry continues, and today, my dear student, lecture number. Kitlam 8 na? Huh? Yeah, lecture number 8. Chapter you know, acid, base, and salt. Now, my dear student, before, as it's practice for all of us that we always discuss some briefing of the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, I gave you an idea regarding pH scale. In today's lecture, we want to just complete the concept of pH scale and what is the importance of pH scale. That is what we are going to discuss in our everyday life. Understand, pH scale plays a very important role in our daily life. That is what we are going to discuss. Understand, the topic today can be called as importance. Topic can be called as importance of pH. Okay, my dear student, let us try to understand importance of pH scale for various aspects of life. Understand, one very important thing we will discuss one by one. Understand, the first one, importance of pH for existence of living organism. Let us try to understand it. First aspect which we are going to discuss, importance of pH for existence of living organism. My dear student, one thing you should know, that every living organism survive because metabolic reaction in their body are working in normal order. If there is some disorder of any metabolic reactions in the body of any living organism, it is going to cause the danger for their survival. So in our body, that means we are talking of every living organism, not only of human being, but in our body, if all the metabolic reaction has to take place normally, all the metabolic activities or reaction has to take place normally, then the pH in our body has to be in the range of 7.2. I am mentioning all pH ranges here. It has to be in the range of 7 to 7.8. Understand, means basic. You understood, no? Right? This has to be the pH range, right? It may be liquid in our body, it may be blood in our body, it may be plasma in our body, it may be lymph in our body. Each and every medium in our body has to have the pH in the range of 7 to 7.8. this is the prefixed range. All metabolic reaction in our body can occur in normal rate and normally and properly only the medium in our body has to possess this range, 7 to 7.8. you must mention one thing, human blood also. Just if I mention, our human blood also possess basic property, you all know, because the pH of human blood is tentatively 7.4. So our blood is also basic. Understand? So all activity, all metabolic reaction in the body of living organism occur in this particular range of 7 to 7.4. If it happens that pH value increases more than 7.4, that is also not proper, and decreases than 7, then also it is a problem. Suppose it happens sometime, if the pH decreases below 7, then our blood becomes acidic and no metabolic reaction can take properly, understand, in our body, and it can cause the danger for the survival of every living organism. Suppose it happens sometime, suppose acid rain has occurred. So when acid rain takes place, the acidic water drains out in the reservoirs, it then drains out everywhere in the water bodies, and this acidic water during the acid rain will lower down the pH less than 7, and because the pH become less than 7, it causes a great danger for the survival of aquatic life. So in for the existence of every living organism, the pH has to be in the range of 7 to 7.8. Understand? Similarly, my dear student, let us mention another aspect which is important for pH, okay? pH for maintaining, you note down, actually in material also, but you can note down here, maintaining soil fertility. Try to understand this. First, as I always write, I will write the pH range for the soil. Understand, that is 6.5 to 7.3. This is quite remarkable range. 6.5 is somewhat acidic, 7.3 means somewhat basic also. Understand, the soil has to be little acidic also. It has to be acidic also. At the same time, it has to be basic also. Means its pH has to be in this range. And farmer, before cultivating any crop, understand, now the today soil testing laboratory are available by even government or private agencies also, where the farmer can get the pH of the soil tested. It has to be in the range of 6.5 to 7.3. If it happens that the pH, understand, after you got tested, and if the pH is less than this, less than 6.5, that means the soil has become more acidic. You understood this? Because the pH has lower down than 6.5, and if the pH decreases, the soil will become more acidic. So to bring the acidity to the level of 6.5, understand, farmer add or mix calcium oxide. This you must remember. Understand, calcium oxide, you all know calcium oxide means that lime powder. Understand, the lime powder has to be taken by the farmer and to be mixed with the soil to ascertain that the pH of the soil comes in the range of 6.5. Contrast to that, if it happens that if a pH goes more than 7.3, means it becomes more basic, then again it is causing a problem for the farmer, because he has to bring pH to the level of 7.3. At that time gypsum is mixed with the soil. Understand, formula of gypsum, I am writing CaSO4 2H2O. You should remember, this is the formula of gypsum, okay? So try to understand it. I am writing here, maybe not visible, lime, okay? So one thing has been clear. the soil has to be, its pH needs to be in the range of this fixed. What is the range? It has to be the range of pH, understood, has to be 6.5 to 7.3, that has been final. And that has to, when can it happen that acidity means the level of pH drops down then 6.5, sometime if some acidic water mix with the soil and acidity increases, basidity also sometime increases, in both the cases it is not suitable for the particular crop cultivation. So if you need a proper crop cultivation, the pH has to be in the range of 6.5 to 7.3. So pH is also important for the maintenance of soil fertility. Understood? So two aspects we discussed, for the existence of living organism, for maintaining soil fertility also, pH is very important. Now let us, I am just erasing these two. Let us discuss the third aspect. Two aspects we already discussed. Now let us discuss the third aspect. What is that? See, third aspect we are discussing now, okay? Third aspect, that is importance of pH in the digestion process, in the digestion process, okay? Let us understand it in quite detail. My dear student, one thing has been very clear in your mind, that in stomach we have already discussed at the time of discussing digestive system also, in stomach actually what happens in stomach, we all know one thing very well, understand that from the inner wall of the stomach, okay, secretion of which three juices take place, which we call digestive hormones, or you can call digestive juices also. Three hormones are secreted, if you can remember the name of that, pepsinogen, pepsin, mucus and dilute HCl. Now my dear student, this pepsin, mucus, okay, but the dilute HCl which is secreted here in the stomach will maintain the range of digestive juices in stomach. This is the particular range, 1, 2, 3, not less than that, understand? Then and then proper digestion take place in our stomach. The range has to be 1 to 3, that is the range. And in that range only, when the food is here acidic, in acidic medium only the digestion process starts properly. But sometimes the range has to be 1 to 3, means quite acidic, understand, in our stomach. What happens sometime? If indigestion take place, then this extra secretion of dilute HCl during indigestion, the dilute HCl which is secreted from the walls of stomach is not utilized, and that unutilized dilute acid causes the problem of burning sensation in the stomach, in even esophagus, and even up to the mouth, that burning sensation which we call acidity, understand? And to remove that acidity you utilize normal anti-acids available at home like baking soda or milk of magnesia, you drink it, even Eno and all are, ultimately the ingredients are all antacids only which are taken by you to neutralize the effect of acidity. Okay, so inside our stomach for the proper digestion, the range has to remain between 1 to 3 for the proper digestion to take place. This range has to maintain, and during acidity actually unused HCl, understand, will play a role for causing the burning sensation throughout the alimentary canal. Understand that is what you call acidity sometime, and it happens also that acidity arises on account of crash dieting also. Some people, normally your stomach is accustomed at amount of hormones. It happens sometime that your stomach is habituated and accustomed according to your daily habit of eating to secrete particular amount of dilute HCl. Every person do not have same diet. Understand, some eat 2 chapatis, some eat 10, some eat 12 also. Every person has different diet. So the dilution of, secretion of HCl from the wall of the stomach has been accustomed according to your regular digestive order. Now if you indulge in a crash dieting and start eating less, but your stomach is actually accustomed for some time being for secretion of more dilute HCl, which can cause acidity. So any person who has acidity, doctor advises not to remain eat proper. That is required to remove even acidity. Baki to you have, sometime we also drink milk also as an antacid to remove acidity. Baki milk of magnesia, baking soda, all are actually particular type of antacids. Understand? So, importance of pH in the digestion. Okay. Now, my dear student, let us understand another name of the antacid I already mentioned. Now the fourth aspect is, that is importance of pH in, not importance, we are just understanding, in preventing understand tooth decay. Let us try to understand it in detail. Actually, what happens? Our teeth enamel, that means the outer layer of our teeth, understand, is actually made up of one hard substance, very hard substance, which is actually called calcium phosphate. Just try to understand the external, suppose our teeth, okay, the external enamel of our teeth is made up of a very hard substance called calcium phosphate. Its formula Ca3PO4 twice. Understand, this hard layer present on our leaf, calcium phosphate layer, it's very hard, understand, and does not corrode easily, right? Okay, but what happens sometime, okay, just try to understand what happens sometime. Suppose we do not develop that habit of taking, we generally do not have that habit of taking food, and after every meal we are not in a habit to brush our teeth, understand, after every meal, after breakfast, even after lunch, after dinner, understand, we are not brushing our teeth. Some people have developed that habit because they understood the importance of that. This actually what happens, at night, suppose we think, at night, many parents are insisting their children to brush their teeth after dinner. Actually what happens, because it's a long duration where your mouth is not active at that time, understand, you are sleeping, what happens? You have taken some food at night, and if you do not brush your teeth, then bacteria, understand, will decompose these food particles which are in the cavity of the teeth or inside the grooving of the teeth. The bacteria actually decompose this food particle, understand, and causes particular type of acids, and as a result the particular type of acid are produced by action of bacteria on the food which you have eaten, on food particle. The pH, understand, of our mouth goes below 5.5, less than 5.5. 5.5 is okay, but less than 5.5, which occurs due to the degradation of food particle by bacteria, understand, present in mouth, and this bacteria decompose and degrade these food particles and produces acid. This acid, which are produced by the degradation of food particle, lowers down the pH of inside mouth less than 5.5, and when the pH become less than 5.5, it is going to affect the outer enamel layer of calcium phosphate of our teeth, and this acid which are produced will cause the corrosion, understand, means decay in the outer layer of our teeth, that has to be removed. How will you do that? So if you, after taking meal, understand, if you brush your teeth after taking your meal, actually all toothpaste are basic in nature, that you all know. All toothpaste, no doubt today the toothpaste are available, means some mints are added, some flavors are added, some extra ingredients are added, that is all okay, antioxidant, active salt, whatever, but the basic property is that every toothpaste are basic in nature. So if you after dinner just brush your teeth, so that basic, understand, the base present in the toothpaste, when you brush your teeth, will neutralize the effect of the acid which may be produced by the degradation of food particle by bacteria, and because the effect of the acid is neutralized by the base which is present in the toothpaste, you can save your outer enamel calcium phosphate for a longer period of time. So that's why it is necessary for you to brush your teeth after every meal, understand. So this is importance of pH in preventing tooth decay also, that also you understand, right? At the same time, my dear student, one more point which we discussed importance for the existence of living organism, importance of pH for soil fertility we mentioned. Then we discussed importance of pH in digestive system. You know the range in digestion, 1 to 3, soil 6.5 to 7.3. Then here we discussed importance of pH in preventing tooth decay. Understand, inside our mouth, the pH range has to remain around 5.5, not less than that. And less than that can take place by degradation of food particle and the production of various acids by bacteria, understand. So that can be, this problem can be easily alleviated if you just brush your teeth regularly after every meal, it is required. Now my dear student, the next point, that is fifth aspect which we are discussing. Okay, four aspect we already discussed. The fifth aspect is this, as a self-defense, okay, let me mention the fifth aspect of importance of pH that is used for self-defense. Self-defense, understand, by various organisms. Self-defense means every living organism has right to protect themselves. Understand, what happens, just take an example, just mention one thing, how the self-defense actually take place. Understood? Just try to understand one important aspect. Suppose honeycomb, which is made by honeybee, understand, with great effort, if somebody try to approach there, then immediately honeybee attack that person or animal, whatever, and actually in the saliva of honeybee, when it bites us, it consisting of melitin acid, that should I mention here. In the saliva of honeybee, when it bites you, contains a particular type of acid, understand, that is melitin. Melitin acid, understand, and because it secretes melitin acids when honeybee bites us, it causes burning sensation on our skin, because as I told you, the metabolic reaction range is that 7 to 7.8, and neutral or basic, not acidic, so any entry of the acid or in blood or any release of the acid on skin will cause the burning sensation. So obviously, how will you remove it? So suppose if honeybee bites you, understand, one or two honeybee you just rub it, understand, but more honeybee attacked you, at that time the only thing is that you should go so find some surrounding or go, understand, and just bath yourself with basic soap. All soap are basic in nature, even baking soda solution also, understand, that is also basic in solution. So you just bath with any soap which are basic in nature, and you can alleviate yourself from any that burning sensation caused by honeybee bite. So that is actually honeybee doesn't want to bite, but she has produced the self-defense for herself, and that's the right of every living organism in this world. Okay, so bite of the honeybee, understand, possess which acid? Melitin acid. At the same time, sometime we utilize the word, my dear student, remember, take an example, sometime we speak like a black ant are very good, they never bite, understand, but actually their bite, when they bite, the saliva does not contain acid, but red ant, it has also developed a self-defense. If red ant, understand, bites you, then it causes burning sensation, because when red ant bites, it leaves actually formic acid, okay, also known as methanoic acid. Formic acid or methanoic acid, understand, which cause burning sensation, but it is not in so much amount, you just rub it and you are able to alleviate the effect of it, understand. At the same time in nature, one plant, suppose nettle leaves actually contains also, suppose nettle leaves, if you just draw, suppose nettle leaves, okay, suppose nettle leaves, okay, so on the nettle leaves there are minute hair like structure, understand, which actually release methanoic acid only, right? So if you just try to touch it, then this methanoic acid in your, on your skin will cause against skin irritation and one type of skin irritation for you. Understand? So my dear student, every animal in the world has got a right for self-defense. Understand? Honeybee, red ant, leaves possess various types of acid for their particular protection only. Understood? So, we understood the importance of everything now. Ant sting, nettle sting, that also. Nettle sting means what? You just touch. It doesn't bite you, but it leaves this methanoic acid, and that causes one type of what we can call a special type of burning sensation on our skin. They are releasing it for their self-defense only. Understood? So, my dear student, one thing which we discussed just now, understand, is importance of pH, significance of pH for so many aspects, understand, in our life. And in exam it happens that you are asked importance of pH for various aspects, for which we have discussed first, importance of pH for existence of living organism, then importance of pH for maintaining soil fertility, then importance of pH in digestion, then importance of pH for maintaining or for preventing tooth decay, and at the same time importance of pH for self-defense developed by various organisms in nature. Understand? So, dear student, the topic which we have discussed today, that was importance of pH in various aspects of life. Here, you should remember the name of the acid which can be asked in one line. Honeybee, melitin, means honey bites, honey bite, honey sting consisting of melitin acid. Red ant bite consists formic acid, also known by the name methanoic acid. Nettle leaves possess again formic acid or methanoic acid, understand, which is dangerous, which can cause burning sensation when released on our skin. Right? So we discussed, let's just have a sum up of the topic which we have discussed. First, importance of pH for the existence of living organism. Our metabolic reaction continues in a proper and normal order in the range of what pH? 7 to 7.8, that you all know, that you need to remember that range. Then second, importance of pH in maintaining soil fertility. Can you remember the range of the soil, or the range of pH for soil? 6.5 to 7.3, that's the range. It should not go less than 6.5, more than 7.3. If it goes less than 6.5, which is the remedial measure farmer has to mix with the soil? Calcium oxide, CaO, lime. And if pH goes more than 7.5, the basidity, to neutralize the basidity and bring it to level of 7.3, the farmer has to add gypsum, CSO4 2H2O, which we are going to discuss, calcium sulfate, in this chapter later on. Okay? Then importance of pH in human digestion. The range of the medium in the stomach is, what is that? 1 to 3, that's the particular range, and it has to be there. Then we discussed importance of pH in maintaining tooth decay. Inside the mouth, the pH range has to be 5.5, not less than that, because less than that, understand, because our saliva is also little acidic. Understand? But less than 5.5 is not proper, and that occurs by not brushing after every meal because the degradation of that food particle by bacteria causes various types of acid which lowers down the pH than 5.5, which can destroy and corrode our teeth enamel, that is calcium phosphate. Then we discussed importance of pH, understand, as a self-defense by various animals, various organisms in the world. Okay, my dear student. So, before we end today's topic, we discussed in our lecture number today importance of pH in various aspects of life. Almost 5 short notes, each and every short notes are very, very important. You need to learn them thoroughly. Okay, so my dear student, for today's lecture, thank you very much from Bharat Sir.